Good morning, gang. It's Friday, the 27th of January 2017. Welcome along to today's United Kingdom Talk. And today, oh yes, check this out. Now this, I've got to tell you, non-Irish Mary, if you ever watch our karaoke streams, non-Irish Mary from Ireland purchased this for me, actually at the end of the last year, so I would wear at some of my karaoke nights, and I haven't worn it yet. There's a particular number that myself and Ray Reynolds do, which is very very warish patriotic type thing, and Union Jacks come out and all that, and I intend to wear this along with the trousers on the said number soon. What keeps happening is that I bring it and then we don't do that number. And then when I don't bring it, they do bring the number. So it's generally in my car. And this morning, I thought as our Right Honourable Theresa May is going to the United States of America, I thought I would give this a little airing this morning. It's very bright and garish, isn't it? We like bright and garish. We can't be doing with just boring colours, you know, grey, magnolia, white with a hint of... No, we need to be bold, dear, bold. That's what we need to be. But I hope you're being bold this morning. Let's say hello to a few early people this morning. Good morning to Shania, who's at work again. Shania, all you do is work, dear. I'm concerned that you're working too hard, my love. Far too much work. Good morning to Shania. Good morning to Jerry Green. Oh, Mary's with us this morning. Good morning, Mary. That's the lady who bought me this. I've got trousers as well. Morning, Mary. John Charles with us this morning. Good morning, John. Hope you're well this morning. OK, Alex Brunt is with us from the US of A. Morning, Alex. And Mary is very pleased that she sees us this morning. And John's very pleased he's caught a live show. Not working this morning. Why is that? Have you been sacked? Oh, don't, dear. Don't joke. One of my friends sent me a little text message yesterday. Tommy, his name is. And he's just been made redundant from the NatWest Bank. Yes. And a lot of that going on. We're all being replaced by machines. I mean, just the banks, for example, you've only got to go in. I mean, a bank branch now. Now, I'm a member. I won't tell you which bank I'm with. I'm a member of a bank, and they haven't. They've got like two machines in there now. Only one of which you can pay in money, because we don't take money out of the bank. Very important. Never take money out of the bank. That's not what it's there for, dear. Don't be taking money out of the bank. You've got to go in, dear. In. So you have the option in my particular bank of either pulling it in an envelope and putting it in the outside machine. Now, I don't like doing that. I never, ever like going to the outside hole in the wall machines. You don't know who's watching. You know, you could be banged over the head, dear. And then that's it. All your money will be stolen and all your personal belongings. Terrible things. So I always, always avoid going to the hole in the wall. If I've got money to pay in, I'll wait until a branch is open. And then I will go into the branch. And they have two machines there. One where I think you can take money out and do various transactions. I guess for people who don't have computers and that thing at home, don't do the home banking sort of thing. And the other one is for all that stuff, plus paying in money. So there's only two machines. And at the other end, there are, I think, four checkouts. What do you call them? Checkouts. Cashiers. Cashier number four, please. Cashier number three, please. Cashier number one, please. Cashier number seven, please. Except they only have four, so it wouldn't be seven. And I wonder if there's a song. I bet someone's done a little song with that. You know, put a bit of beat behind it. Boom, boom, boom. Cashier number one, please. Da, 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 da. Anyway, so those four are at the end. So we've still got quite a few cashiers. Number four, please, in my particular bank. But I have noticed a lot of the banks now. I mean, you go in and it's full of machines. There's these machines must cost an arm and a leg, mustn't they? I'm thinking of having one installed outside my front door, just in case anyone wants to pay any money in there. Yes, please. Thank you very much. We need more money. The more money that comes, I promise, I make you this promise. The more money you put in my personal cash machine outside my front door, the more money I will put into the church collection plate on Sunday. We need the church painted. Desperate, dear, desperate. Anyway, so you go in his HSBC, and Barclays, actually, here in, is it Barclays? Or it might be Nat West. Might be Nat West. You go in and it's just full of machines. You know, about 10 of them all sitting there, and people tapping away and doing stuff and that. When I go and pay money in, if it's to a member of family, I go, all they do is give me the number. They give me their, and I never write them down. So I always, oh, I just want to put some money in your account. What's your details? And they give me their sort code and their account. And you go to this machine in the, I think it's HSBC, that one. I'm sure it is. And you go to this machine and you type in the sort code, of which two numbers are already there. That must be the perhaps identification of the bank or something like that. So you type in the sort code and then you type in the account code. And then it says, you don't know, I don't think you type in how much money you put in. This little drawer opens like that. Little drawer opens. And, you know, you look in there and hopefully someone dropped a sweet in there, but there's nothing in it. And you put your notes in. No coins. No coin. I don't know what you're supposed to do with all these coins, dear. Oh, by the way, you want to get rid of those pound coins soon? That's changing it. We're getting a new pound coin note. Aren't we? Not note, but you know what I mean. We're getting a new pound coin soon with little size. Like a thruppity bit. We're just going back in time all the time. Like a thruppity bit. That's what it's like. So you drop these notes in. And then you don't have to do it. And then it closes. Whoa. I mean, blimey, it nearly takes your bloody hand off, dear. They must be desperate for your money. As you drop the notes in, you don't get a second chance to put more in at that point. It, whoa, like that, it closes so quickly. And then I think it might. And then it does. And then it comes up on a little screen. How many notes you put in? How clever is that? And it doesn't seem to matter if there's a bit of writing. You know, sometimes people write on, I don't know, I think it's, I'm sure it's illegal to do that. But they write on banknotes how much money, you know, if someone's been, like in a shop or something, they've been counting the money, and then, oh, it's 50 quid. And then they put 50 on the top there in a little circle so that they know for their own benefit. It doesn't seem to make any difference in this bank. How, if you've written on there or they're slightly torn, it just takes the money off you. I'm going to try Monopoly money. I think I might try some Monopoly money to see if I can get away with that in there. What do you reckon? Hey? And then I think it gives you a chance to add more. It says, do you want to add more? No. Da, 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 da. And then that's it. Done. And a little receipt comes out and that's it. But it doesn't, like, say, it doesn't give you the name of the person that you're paying in. It's just numbers. And I've often sat there, and that's it. And I thought, oh, did I put the right numbers in? Because you don't know, do you? You don't know. You might have sent the money incorrectly to someone else. God. And then what happens? What happens if you was to do that? Can you get it back? Is there some way of getting that cash back? That's the worry. I don't want other people to have my cash if I'm sending it to certain other people. Blimey. Anyway, so my mate has recently been sacked for a bank. I think you don't get sacked and that don't come in tomorrow. I don't think it works like that. I think he finishes in June, but he's been made redundant. Of course, replaced by another machine. You know, and this is going on left, right and centre. These robots are coming, my friend. There's nothing you can do about it. One by one, everything's being replaced by a machine. What are we all going to do? That's the thing. I'm quite amazed, you know, often, you know, when like you're perhaps purchasing something from an online retailer or you're on a technical help desk, but not actually on the phone, but, you know, typing. What's it called? Like a personal assistant. As a hello, a little screen comes up. Hello, how may I help you? And you type in, looking for a telly. Just a moment. Hello, my name's Julie. How may I help? I say Julie because Julie is the lady, one of the ladies in customer services in Waitrose, who sits on the customer services there. Oh, lovely ladies. That's why I'm using the term Julie. But it might not necessarily be Julie. You understand what I mean? So so you're typing in your question. Oh, looking for a 65-inch telly. Incidentally, if you have got a 65-inch television that you don't and it no longer want, please send it over to me. I'm looking for a nice curved screen 65-inch television, but I don't want to have to pay for one. They're still a little bit pricey. I'm still waiting for them to come below the £800 mark. Thank you, yes. At the moment, they're about 113, I think 1213, something like that. So you type in your question, look at it, and it says, okay, Chris, it asks your name. What's your name? It says, I'm Julie. Well, okay, Chris, hold on, I'll have a look for you. And then you get an answer back, right? Some people think that's someone typing at the end. It's not. It's a computer. Generally, you're talking to a computer. Not all the time. Sometimes it's a real person. Sometimes it's a computer. There's no one at the other end. So slowly but surely, we're all being taken over by computers. We are. I mean, half of them are walking around in the street looking at their mobile phone. Zombies, dear. Zombies, that's what they are. So there we are. Watch out for the robots. A lot of things are about to be replaced by robots. And you think your job's safe? You know, who ever thought there would be a self-driving car? All those dreadful, ghastly Uber drivers at some point will lose their jobs. Hooray! Then we might be able to move around from A to B at a reasonable speed. Oh dear. John Child says, I used to work, John C. I used to work in Barclays as the person showing you how to use the machines. No cashiers in that particular branch. You see, he's lost his job to a machine. Haven't you? The machines can also tell if you put counterfeit currency in. Well, Monopoly money isn't counterfeit currency, is it? That's real Monopoly money, surely. I mean, I sit there and I roll the dice and I buy a few more houses. Well, it's like real life to me. That's what I do. Mary says, I prefer people in supermarkets too. Oh, yes, those awful self-service tills. Now, the one in Sainsbury's, you know I'm not a fan of Sainsbury's. Oh, is it 10 o'clock? Have I had my pills? Yes, I've had my pills. The self-service in Sainsbury's, you just feel that you're being looked at all the time, don't you? They stand there in the middle. There's like one, I think there's about eight of them in Sainsbury's. And they stand there at the end watching you. And they don't smile and they are as miserable as sin in Sainsbury's. As miserable. We went up there, I had to go up there the other day, only because it's close. But it's not my choice of supermarket at all. They are so, not only the staff, the customers as well. The customers, they look faces like they got thunder as they walk out of that shop. But I hate them. I know what you mean. Oh, good morning to James Dean. Good morning, James. Did you know the lovely Nicki French is on the Victoria Derbyshire show this morning? Did you know that? Yes. She's on, I think, 10:40, something like that. I did see it on her Facebook last night. Nicki French is a lovely, lovely lady. She gets a lot. She does a lot of work, pantomimes, singing cabaret, and she represented the United Kingdom in the Eurovision Song Contest a number of years ago. She's going to be on the Victoria Derbyshire show this morning. So I did send her a bit of message. Haven't you? You've got to be posh to be on her show because Victoria Derbyshire is very posh, isn't she? Very, very posh and aloof. I'm sure she's nice, but she comes across as very, very posh. And I said to Nicki, lovey, I don't know if you're going to fit in on that, my love. I'm not sure that she will fit in with the posh Victoria Derbyshire, James. Perhaps you'll send her a little text. Is she tweeting while she's on air or something like that? Oh, dear. Oh, blooming cough's back again. Oh, excuse me. Good morning to Tony Power. Tony, did you know Nicki French was on? You know Nicki French. Did you know she's on Victoria Derbyshire this morning? I think at about 10:40. Well, I might as well. I'll have to go off air by 10:40 because no one will be watching then. Everyone will be watching the delicious Nicki French on the Victoria Derbyshire show on BBC News 24. Boop, boop, ba, 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 ba. Boop. I love the music to that. Incidentally, if you want to call in at any point this morning, we have a phone line open, boys and girls. Just one. Only one. We have a phone line open. It's a local London number. 020-8144-3477 is the number. Now, only if the show's live. How do you know the show's live? There'll be a little live indicator flashing away somewhere on your screen. If you can't see that, then you're watching a recording. All right, my loves. So if you want to call in, you can do so. The phone line is now open. Local London number 020-8144-3477. 020-8144-3477 is the phone number. We also have Skype. If you have Skype, gang, you can Skype in. And my Skype in number, my Skype in name is, all one word, United Kingdom Talk. So Skype in, if you've got Skype, United Kingdom Talk, all one word, right, United Kingdom Talk, or phone in 020-8144-3477. If you're quite happy to just sit there and let me rab it on my own, that's fine as well. You're not forced. We don't force you to do anything. Not on this programme, dear. No forcings are going on, all right? Good morning to Joan, who's with us this morning. Morning, Joan. Ben Parker says, are the bank machines designed by Arkwright or Open All Hours? Well, the ones that I use, that's not in my bank, but the ones in HSBC are, whoa, they slam shut the moment you put those notes in. You can't change your mind. Not like having a person. You know when you're at the bank machine and you're counting out some money, you know, 5, 10, 15, 20... 25, they give it 25. Oh, no. Can I just take a fiver back? I haven't got any shopping. Oh, dear. No chance with the HSBC machines. It's closed. That's it, mate. You ain't getting that back. Oh, dear. Mary, non-Irish Mary from Ireland, says she has a robot Hoover, as she told us the other week. Oh, yes. Yes. She pushes a couple of buttons and off it goes. It's a little flat round thing. I can't remember if I showed it to you now. She did send me a little a video. I'm sure we showed it to you. And she pushes the button and it just goes around the room. And then when it hits something, and it turns around. You know, very, very good. I wonder how cats would get on with one of those. Have you got a cat, Mary? I can't remember now. Do you have a pussy cat? I thought I saw a pussy cat walking out on me. I did, I saw a puddy cat, as sweet could be. Yes. Oh, talking of Eurovision, I nearly forgot. We've got the Song for Europe type thing tonight. I don't know what they call it now, actually. But that's where we are played, and I've been doing it on BBC Radio 2, 88 to 91 FM. This is Radio 2 from the BBC. They've been playing them on Radio 2 this week. And tonight on BBC 2... But they've shifted it over to BBC. I'm sure it used to be on one. Apparently they've shifted it. Is that right? BBC Two Song for Europe. Let's have a look. Let me just double check for you. Two Song for Europe. I don't know what they call it now. Of course, no one's going to vote for us, are they? Let's have a... Is that it? No, that's it. No. Oh, yeah. 1 minute. BBC Radio 2. Oh, no. No. What's on? When? No. One moment. No. Song contest final. No. I think Wendy said it was on BBC Two tonight. So they've shoved that over to BBC Two. Perhaps someone will know that. Ah, here we are. Tony says, Tony, you know, Tony, is it on BBC Two? Tony says, I'm hopeful that Olivia Garcia will take the prize tonight with her song Freedom Hearts. I can only hope whoever goes to You Decide brings a flask of coffee with them. The songs are rather dreary. Oh, we do like a ballad. I don't mind a ballad as long as it's a good ballad. But we've had some good ballads and I haven't got anywhere. So that programme tonight is... Is it called You Decide? Something like that. And I think it's on BBC Two. So they sing, aha, there's a phone call coming in. How exciting. Good morning on line one. Who's that, please? Hello?
Hello, Chris.
Oh, you'll have to turn your computer off. We can hear you.
Hang on just a minute, I'll turn it
down. Oh, it is Tony. It's Tony. He knows everything there is to know about Eurovision. Good morning,
Hello,
Tony.
Chris.
All right. Now, is it on BBC Two Colour tonight?
It is on BBC Two. It'll run on the same line as the actual show itself.
You know,
At the Apollo and Hammersmith. You're running at the same time. I think so. You're talking about 7 o'clock, I'd imagine.
7 o'clock on BBC Two Colour.
Yeah. So
why have they shoved it over to BBC Two? They're losing interest. I'm telling you now.
I think, you know, they had it on BBC 4 last year. I think.
Oh, did they? Oh.
Yeah. So, you know, so they moved it back to BBC 2. But I don't know why they did that. But anyway, I'm certainly not going for the first time for a long time. So.
Oh, you're not going? Why is that then?
I just can't be bothered. I'm going to Brighton anyway because one of my songs has been performed at a local pantomime down there, so I'm quite looking forward to that.
Oh, but, excellent. Is that the one you wrote for Miss Jason, Drag Queen
Miss Jason? It's one I did for Miss Jason, yes. she's performed. Well, I don't know exactly what the lineup is down there. So
I hope she remembers the words this time.
Oh, God.
Oh, bless her. Do you know what? She was so nervous about forgetting the words. And I think when you get that nervous, you do forget words. I find it incredibly difficult to learn words.
It's a lot easier if it's a song that you're familiar with listening to for years. You know,
yes.
Say it's some pop song you've learned back in your youth or something like that. But for a new song, it's a lot more difficult. You know, basically, when we did the song in the studio, it was very, very difficult indeed. So, you know, because Jason, I had to go over it again and again with Jason. But bless him, you know, he did very well in the end to pick it up and learn it. So, but when he went to do his shows, it was a bit more difficult for him to remember the words, you know. So
yes, of course it is. Of course it is. Ben Park has just written, yes, it's on BBC Two tonight at 7:30.
I'm not going, but I'm going to be going to the Eurovision party. I've got a VIP invite to that. So,
all right.
I should meet the winner there anyway.
How lovely.
And chat to the winner there.
It's surprising how quickly it comes around. Now, I was looking at the people who are going in for this tonight. Was one of them that lad who was on The X Factor?
Oh, Daniel, you mean?
It was him, wasn't it? Yes, I thought so.
Now, he's got a reasonably good song. He's a better vocalist, but I think the song is not really a Eurovision song. I don't think there's any real Eurovision songs amongst the bunch that they've got there tonight. I've got my own views about that, and I wouldn't like to be talking about. But I think everybody has their own views about why Eurovision songs are the way they are for the UK this past 15 years.
Oh yes,
so,
yes.
And they're not getting anywhere.
He used to come to the karaoke at the Black Cap, you know. Yes, he did. Honestly, years ago, and I remember the very very first time he came, and he sung his song, and it was James Brown. Get up, yeah. I feel like being a sex machine. You know that one? He sung
that one.
And when he finished, as he left the stage, I said, you are going to be a massive singer. He's like, why'd you say that? He said to me, why you say that? I said, because I just know you are fantastic. You sing, you perform, you're nice. And I said, you watch, you'll be a massive singer. And then the next thing I knew, he was on The X Factor. How fantastic is that? I love seeing things like that.
I think he's got a great voice, but unfortunately, he hasn't got the right song, you know.
Right, okay. Yeah, that's a fair point, yeah.
If he had something a bit more on the Eurovision lines, I think he'd be a pretty good chance, but I just don't think he's got it. I don't think he's got the right song. But I think he's my second choice, actually, of the ones that are there. But I think Olivia Garcia, been 16 years of age, I think she's going to blow them away.
With 16. God, yeah. She's young to do that, isn't she?
I think she's probably, if I remember correctly, the second youngest UK artist to take part at Eurovision. I think the youngest was one a girl called Emma back in.
Give a little love back to the world.
Yeah, that's the one. Yeah, yeah. That's some years ago. I can't remember what year it was.
Give a little love back to the world. Oh, lovely song. She didn't win, though, did she?
And I think Graham Sark or something like that. But that's going back a few years ago. But I just don't think that the UK had produced anything in the line of a potential Eurovision winner since Katrina, obviously, you know. But I just wonder how interested the BBC are in really wanting to win the contest. That's my honest opinion. But
you don't think they want to win it, no?
I personally
is it the old money?
I think what they've done this year and for many years now is trying to pull the wool over people's eyes by putting in six average songs. Well, I'm not saying they're average songs.
Yeah.
I'm saying they're good songs, but they're not in the field of Eurovision at all.
Do you actually think anyone's going to vote for us?
The thing is, everybody's looking on and saying, "Oh, they're much better songs this year." Of course, they're much better songs this year, but they're not Eurovision songs, and not one of them songs has got a cat in hell chance of winning.
I've been on the phone this morning just before we came on air to President Vladimir Putin. To see if he can interfere with the scoring and give us a bit of a leg up. Vladimir Putin. Hello. Yeah, you helped Donald. Yes. Can you do anything for our Eurovision song this year? And he said he'd look into it. But I have to promise to buy so much more extra gas from them first, dear. And I said to him, the only gas that I ever get in this house is when my sister comes round to visit, dear. Oh! Dreadful, dear.
Well, anyway, I had a lovely message from Ireland yesterday, anyway, and they told me that my entry for there was unsuccessful and that they had 330 entries.
You keep banging away at it, Tony. All right, my darling.
But yeah, they've picked a song now. It'll be interesting to see what they have picked for Brendan Murray.
Yes.
Who's the guy that's going to be representing Ireland. But he's actually got a very unusual voice. He's got a voice of a boy of 14 rather than his age of 20, you know.
Is it quite high pitched, is it?
Oh, very high pitched. Sounds like he's on helium, basically.
Do you watch The Voice?
I've sort of watched a few of the singers this year, and actually the quality is a little bit better this year.
I really like the black guy that was on there. He was on last week, quite thin, tall, quite gay. And he opened his mouth and it was very operatic. They didn't turn around because, you know, obviously they're looking for a pop star. But I thought he was from London. I thought he had a most wonderful voice.
I think I know what you mean.
Yeah.
Actually, yeah. Yeah. I must say that the quality of vocalists on The Voice is far better than any of the other shows, I think.
And what about Let It Shine? You know, do you like that?
Proper vocalists are going there. People with raw vocal talent. Are going there because they don't necessarily have to be seen. You
yes,
know,
yes.
What about to be heard.
What yeah. about Let It Shine? Do you see that?
Let It Shine. What was that one again? Was...
BBC One Colour, Saturdays.
You mean the one with...
Gary Barlow. Yeah.
I don't know what to make of that, actually. It's sort of... I haven't really got into it very much.
No, that's very common. Sometimes I like the way the stars light up. I particularly like it when they don't get to the top.
Oh yeah, there was one boy there last week, and I think he got pissed to the very last one, and I felt sorry for him actually because I thought he was actually quite.
Was
good.
That the one who had? There was one of them that had a go at the judges. It didn't quite get there, and he had a go at the judges. The big lady who sits on the end from Glee. What's her name?
I'm not sure.
She's fab. I love her to bits. She is wonderful. I'd like to meet her.
But she's one of these ones that definitely doesn't, you know, is not afraid to say what she thinks.
Yes, but. Yes. Well, thanks. Danny Minogue's like that. She tells them what she thinks, Danny Minogue.
Oh, Danny, oh, God. She's something else, isn't she?
Oh, dear. Well, thanks for calling in, Tone. Lovely to talk to you.
It's a pleasure, absolutely.
All right, cheerio now.
Yeah, chat soon.
Yeah, bye-bye, Tony.
Bye now, bye.
There's our Tony. He loves the Eurovision. He writes songs for the Eurovision Song Contest as well. Let me just type this in there. One moment, please. I like to give people a name so I know who's calling in then. Lovely. Good morning to Ray Reynolds is with us this morning. Good morning to superstar Ray Reynolds. ex-DJ, a member of the Dawn Formby Max Miller Appreciation Society. Good morning, Ray. Also a member of British Music Hall Society, home of music hall and variety. Blimey, it goes on and on, Ray. I mean, how many titles have you got? Good morning to Elaine, who says, I love your patriotic jacket. Thank you very much, Elaine. Good morning to Ben Parker, again, who says, Strictly Come Dancing's Bruno Tonioli, singer Sophie Alex-Bexter and vocal coach CC Sammy will judge the singers at the event at the Hammersmith Polo in London. This is the Song for Europe thing tonight. I can't just keep losing the title. After the performance, the public will choose their favourite song before voting to send their choice to the Eurovision contest in Kiev, Ukraine. The singer, Daniel Donch Johnson. He's the guy that he's got a fantastic voice and personality. Daniel Johnson is the one that used to come to my karaoke's at the Black Cap in Camden, which is no longer open. Lucy Jones, who both reached the live shows of The X Factor 2009. Natty Simpson, Olivia Garcia, who crashed out of last year's series at the Judge's House, Relative Unknowns, Selena Mastroianni, and Holly Brewer, who both auditioned for the show, will also battle it out at Eurovision You Decide. That's it called, Eurovision You Decide. The programme will be hosted by previous Great British Bake Off presenter, Mel. Oh, we like Mel. I like Mel. She's good. With each of the singers performing a different song. So thank you very much. Mary says on the subject of her robotic Hoover, the cat hates it. Mary's pussy does not like the Hoover. How awful. How awful. I bet you set that thing to chase the cat round, don't you? That's the sort of thing I would do. I won't lie to you. I won't lie to you. Elaine says Eurovision is like a religion here in Israel. It certainly is. Yeah, it certainly is. And seeing the word Israel there has reminded me to tell you that today is International Holocaust Remembrance Day, boys and girls. It's an international memorial day today commemorating the victims of the Holocaust. Terrible, terrible, terrible thing that was when an estimated, when they do estimates, it's always more, isn't it? 6 million Jewish people, 2 million Romani people, 250,000 mentally and physically handicapped, disabled people, 9,000 homosexual men killed, wiped out by the Nazi regime. And we're remembering that as well today, boys and girls. There are people, strange people. I have to say, I just don't understand where their mentality comes from, to be honest, that try and say that it didn't actually happen. I mean, I don't know how you can say that. Thanks for calling. I'll be with you in a second. If you could just hold a moment, all right?
Hello, is this BBC Radio Box?
Yeah, I'll be with you in a minute, Ross. They say that it never happened. I mean, how you can walk around and say that something like that happened. I mean, the bloody building, I'm sorry to swear, the buildings are there to go and see. In Auschwitz and places like that. Dreadful. Dreadful, dreadful. And people were wiped out like that. And it's just horrendous. A couple of films that really, really give me cold sensations up my back. Schindler's List. You want to see that one. But even worse than that for me, and I don't know why, it really struck a chord with me. The Boy in the Striped Pyjamas. Which is just horrendous. And you should watch it. You should watch it and understand. Well, I mean, understand as far as you can. I mean, you weren't there, were you? You weren't there in the gas chambers. You weren't there having experiments done upon you. You know, the odd thing is, most of us are sitting here today because of experiments done on those poor Jewish people. I think I think I'm right in saying when the war was over, the authorities, the Nazi authorities, were forced to hand over all the information that they'd done on diseases and that sort of thing. So that's what we're remembering as well today, boys and girls, the Holocaust Day and those people that lost their lives. OK, let's go to the phones now. Ross is on the phone from Norwich. Are you from Norwich? Good morning, Ross.
Hello, is this BBC Radio Berkshire?
No, this is not BBC Radio Berkshire. Tony Blackburn is on BBC Radio Berkshire, a far, far more enjoyable candidate for entertainment than I am, and that's why the figures are so low on this Friday morning. Thank you.
I'd like to report a traffic problem, please, to your presenter.
What's the traffic problem?
There's a queue in traffic in Church Street in Bracknell at the moment.
Is there?
Yeah, I think everyone's stuck behind a broken-down tractor.
Well, what do you want me to do about it?
Well, this is BBC Radio Berkshire, isn't it?
No, it's not BBC Radio Berkshire. This is United Kingdom. This is not a local station. This is global. This is worldwide, international television programme you're speaking to now. Not a small, local BBC station.
Will you be playing the 10 at 10?
What's that, the 10 at 10? What's that?
When you play 10 songs in a row at 10 o'clock.
We don't play music here. How long have you been listening for?
Huh.
Now, Ross, I seem to remember when I was on that internationally acclaimed radio station, Play Talk USA, you would do this there. You would ring in and you'd say, hello. And I'd say, yep, hello. What do you want to talk about? And then you'd say, why, what are you talking about? You hadn't even bothered listening. You just rang in. Is it the same this morning? What have we been talking about this morning? What have we been talking about this morning? Any idea?
I don't know, because I've only just got on my break. I don't sit and listen to you for 24 hours a day waiting, do I?
Is that what you do? Do you ever ring up LBC? Just suddenly ring. Oh, hello. Hello, yeah. Is that LBC? Yeah. Oh, I don't know. I haven't been listening. I mean, what's the point of that?
So what are you talking about? Are you talking about air pollution or CCTV? What are you talking about?
No, we're not talking about anything like that. You go away. Go back to the beginning of the show. Watch a bit and call back in.
Not really the attitude, is that?
This is what customer services is all about. Customer services.
I think I might go and listen to Radio BBC Radio Berkshire. At least
good.
The presenter, they'll be
good.
Be kinder to me.
Good. Bye bye.
Up yours then.
Bye bye.
Up yours then.
Yeah, bye bye. Go on, off you go. Off you go. No, I'm not putting the phone down. You put the phone down first.
No, you put the phone down. Oh, go on. No, you put the phone down. No, I can't.
I'm not putting the phone down. You put the phone down.
I will crack my screen if I put my phone down.
Oh, is it a cheap old thing? Is it, I bet it's not even a smart... Is it a Nokia 6310i? Ah! Is it? Is that what it is? Is it an iPhone 3? God's sake, man.
I've heard about where you live.
Yeah, and? What's the point?
Caravans outside the front gardens.
Nothing wrong with caravans. I'm a big fan. Will you put the phone down? Go.
Wheelie bins all hanging out the top of the lid.
In the words of Scott Fitzgerald, go before you break. My heart once more is what we're absolutely waiting for. Have you gone yet?
No, not yet. Common as muck.
I'm surprised you've got phones in Norwich.
Yes, I will be ringing up BBC Radio Berkshire so I can have an intellectual conversation with someone a little bit more talented, I think.
Right, okay then, bye! Go on, go!
Go on, what are you talking about? What's your topic?
I'm not going to tell you. You can't just ring up and not know what the bloody hell was going on. You've got to watch the bit of the show and then say, that's interesting, I'll call in. That's how it works. How long have you been into radio? Years. How can you not know how it works? How thick can you be, dear?
Well, it's just nice to talk to someone.
I mean, how old is your daughter now? Five?
Three and six.
Three and six. I suggest you put one of them on the phone. They know what the hell's going on.
Maybe I will then.
Have they taught you how to work your phone? Oh, that's the problem. What they've done is taught you how to dial a phone number on that mobile phone, but not actually taught you the smart facilities on it to watch this programme wherever you are in the world, dear.
Anyway, just before I go, you know Ronnie, you and Ronnie, I think you two should enter to be on Gogglebox. I think you two would be really good on there.
What's that, Gogglebox? What's that?
Gogglebox, where they sit and watch telly.
What side is that on?
Gogglebox. You never watched Gogglebox on Channel 4?
No, never. On what?
They got a Gogglebox on Channel 4. They film people watching TV shows.
How totally and utterly uninteresting.
Okay.
I bet you watch Big Brother as well, don't you?
No, I don't. Actually,
yeah, and
no,
the only one is Essex.
Vile.
Made in Chelsea.
Really
the X Factor. Yeah, we know what sort of person you are. Have you got a little area attached to the side of your caravan, have you?
No, I watch EastEnders.
Oh, my Lord.
Do you live near where they film EastEnders? Is that near Berkshire?
No, used to be Elstree, didn't it? I don't think it's there
Elstree
anymore,
Studios,
though.
Yeah.
Elstree, yes. It might have been Elstree, somewhere like that.
Is that near yours?
No, I'm in Bracknell in Royal Berkshire.
Hmm. All right, and I might as well go and talk to someone else then.
Good, bye-bye. Bye. How long does it take you to put the phone down?
I don't know.
Let me help you. There's Ross calling in from Norwich. Just a minute. Do you know how many years he's been doing that? What he does, he sees your number flash up on the thing and he rings it. But he hasn't got a clue what he wants to talk about. What is all that about? Thank you, Ross, for calling in. Elaine says, next time you come here, I'll take you to Yad Vashem. It'll be an experience to remember. Is that the Holocaust Museum? I have been there. I have been to the Holocaust Museum. And it's just terrible in there. Just terrible. There's the bit that did it was me. There was little videos playing all over the place in this hall. And there was an elderly lady on there. And she said there was a knock at her door. Obviously in Germany. There was a knock at the door. And her mum shoved her upstairs. I can't remember if she was on her own or with someone else now. She shoved her upstairs and hid her in a cupboard, you know, like behind the cupboard. You know, you've got your things hanging up in a cupboard, like your coats. And she pushed her behind there. And she says, stay in there. Whatever you do, do not come out. If whatever you hear, don't come out. Right? So that's it. The mother went and opened the door. And then she couldn't hear what was being said, of course. And then she came back upstairs. She come upstairs, opened the cupboard. She said, right, me and your dad are going now. You make sure you look after yourself. Do not come downstairs until everything's gone quiet. And don't forget, we love you. And then she closed the cupboard door, and that's the last time she ever saw her mother. The last time. Isn't that just dreadful? And that's that really did me in, that did, when I saw that little video like that. And then you walk a bit further in this museum, and then there's this like bit of glass in the floor. And when you're at a distance, you can't quite see what it is. There's a bit of glass in the floor. And you go over and there's all these little shoes, children's shoes in there. And it's just awful. And if you ever go to Israel, you must go there to the Holocaust Museum. You'll need a day. They don't like you to take pictures. I mean, people, they ask, you know, and people are taking pictures. How disrespectful is that? Disrespectful. But, you know, if you go, don't take pictures. They've asked you not to take them, so don't take pictures. Just go in there and it's just, it's all there. It's all there. So I think that's where you mean there, Elaine. All right, my love. Okay, there we go. Right, Adam says, please wear the jacket tonight. Okay, hello, Dolls. Dolls, it was now Dolls, Dolls Buffet there. She is on a tiny little island in the South Pacific called Norfolk Island. It is the most beautiful little place in the world. And I have been lucky enough to be there twice while my cousin was doing the police. He was running a little police force. That they were a very small police force. Well, it was a very small island. He was running the little police force that they had on the island. So I went 2 years in a row. Actually, it's a number of years ago. And Dolls, you know what I've got up here? Let me show you this, Dolls. I hope you're still there. Look what I've got up here. 1 minute. Oh, dear. Hang on, there it is. Look what I've got here, Dolls. All right. I shall never, ever get rid of this. And I did a little job for the police out there. I DJ'd for some teenage group that they have there. And the people of the island bought me this. And on the back it says, thank you very much from the Blue Light Council, Norfolk Island, summer 2010. See that? Look, that there. And I had to get this. I had to bring it back through customs. Now, Australia are very... I could actually put this here somewhere, couldn't I? I suppose. Yeah. Let's, I don't know if I can. Maybe up there or somewhere. I must put that up. And the people of Norfolk Island, when you go back into the mainland Australia, their customs are very strict. And I had to declare this. And the bloke takes it out of the bag and looks at it. I think he checks for woodworm and insects and things like that. And I was given permission to bring it through. And I said, I'll open my case for you. He said, have you got anything else? I said, no. He said, no, that's OK. We believe you. Go through with that. I suppose the very fact that I showed them that was good enough to them. So I've still got that, Dials. Isn't that wonderful? If you ever get the chance to visit Norfolk Island, go. It's a quiet place. All right, very, very quiet there. So there we are. Hello to Lily this morning. Adam's with us this morning. Hello, Timmy. Timmy says, good morning from Lord Timothy Thomas, former customer at the Black Cabin, the only member of the LTT Appreciation Society. Good morning to Jason Lewis. Morning, Jason. Hope you're well, sir. Nice to see Jason. What else have we got here? Ross is still there this morning. He's still there. Ross, please have a subject ready when you're going to ring up. Yes, Dials is indeed still there. The clock from Norfolk Island. Isn't it beautiful? That's a lovely piece of stuff there. Lily says, can you greet a very good friend? Gary Armstrong is 56 today. So let's say hello and a very happy birthday to Gary. Gary Armstrong, 56 years old today. Happy birthday, Gary. Those of you on my Facebook with your birthdays, that's coming up at the end of the show. Right, boys and girls. Don't forget, there's a phone line if you want to call in this morning. It's 020-8144-3477, OK? 020-8144-3477. Got an email here from Wizzo, which came in yesterday. He came along to the quiz on Wednesday night at the King's Head Theatre Bar. I won a little quiz there. We're coming up to year three. I've been doing it there for year three, and it's a fantastic place to work. The staff are brilliant. The customers are brilliant. It's just a wonderful, wonderful place to work. It can be a bit of an effort getting in. It really can. And they really look after me there. They do. They really always have a cup of tea and a little bit of cake there. And Wizzo was there on Wednesday night. So that's where, if you're ever in London area on a Wednesday, it's the King's Head Theatre Bar in Upper Street, Islington, every Wednesday from 8:30. It's nice and easy. We take it. If you see this as this show is now and add questions to it, OK, that would be the quiz. We're not too serious. The only thing I don't like is cheating. I get very upset. You know, I had to personally murder five people a few weeks ago when I caught an entire team cheating. Yes. What we did, we put poison in their drinks and they literally died while they were doing their quiz. But, you know, and other people who were disgusted. They were disgusted. Not at me, at the cheats. They were disgusted at the cheats and they assist us in dragging the bodies outside and leaving them. Not hiding them, leaving them on the paper, on the pavement outside the pub, so that other people who were coming past said, oh, we better not cheat in there. You see, that's what we need. Examples put of people. The Saudis have got it right. You know, if you nick something, cut their blooming hands off. Yes, dear. Cut their hands off. That's what you got to do. We need to make examples of people. Yes. And we did that at the quiz on Wednesday night when the bodies were dragged outside and left. They were left. Now, the funny thing is, the next week I came past and the binman hadn't been. And there were disfigured members' bodies laying out there, which were decomposing. But oh, I mean, the smell was, we had to move them further down the road outside an Italian restaurant. The smell and the flies everywhere. It was disgusting. And that their eyes had been pecked out by the pigeons. Pecked out, yeah. Anyway, let's go back to this email. Hi, Chris, says Wizzo. A very enjoyable quiz on Wednesday at the King's Head Theatre. Thanks. Yes, you are right. I'm pretty useless on mainstream pop music under 20 years old. Now, which is unusual because Wizzo is a DJ, boys and girls. He is a radio DJ on Hospital Radio Romford. That's where we're Hospital Romford FM Radio Hospital. Yes. And he says, yes, you are right. But he's not very good on the music round. How can that be? On a music radio station, dear. Hospital Radio Romford. Yes. He says, I find it a bit bland, to be honest. What, the music of the day? Oh, too right. too right. Isn't it awful? Someone made the mistake last night of asking for Beyonce drunk in love. I don't think so. No. A team name, Flowers in the Rain. They have a little team name. There was him, Ray Reynolds, and... Oh, I can never remember the other bloke's name now. Might have been Paul. Our team name, Flowers in the Rain, was a little nod to the first record ever played on BBC Radio 1 by the legend that is Tony Blackburn, who is at this moment, boys and girls, on BBC Radio Berkshire. Yes, every Friday. Every Friday. 30th September 1967 was when that station opened up. It was number two in the charts at the time. A good little song written by Roy Wood and performed by The Move. Da, da, da. Going down flowers in the rain. That one, yes. The royalties still go to charity after Harold Wilson sued the band over the use of his image in promoting it. A bit unfair, as it was the band's management that committed the crime. Do I swear on the radio? Because we've had this discussion about people swear. Radio 4 are swearing. You know when you listen to the play in the afternoon? I bet you don't. You've never heard a Radio 4 play, have you? They have plays on in the afternoon. But they have swearing on there. Can you believe that? Swearing on Radio 4. Do I swear on the radio? Sorry to disappoint you, but no. Good. I don't swear on the radio. You don't get an f from me or a k. Yeah, you don't get any of that from me. No, thank you very much. He says, but no, sorry to disappoint, but no, I don't. It's not my style, really. I have been tempted, but it's not happened yet. Oh, we all get tempted. You all get tempted, don't we? Eh? I mean, sometimes I'm walking around with my microphone stick and I can see people are tempted by my looks. I can. And, you know, sometimes you're walking around with the microphone, Wizzo, and you feel someone suddenly brush past your bottom. I don't usually look round. But, you know, they're having a little feel. I mean, I don't mind that. I don't mind that. You know, some of these people are so up themselves. They really are. And someone brushes past, they take them to court. Sexual harassment. I don't mind. I think it's pathetic to do that. I mean, quite frankly, why these people do that, men and women, they take people to court. Sexual harassment. Quite honestly, I don't know how you ever managed to find anyone in your sad, pathetic lives. We do like a bit of touch. And if you don't stay indoors. Stay indoors. Lock yourselves in, for Christ's sake. Oh, the royalties. Hang on a minute. I love hospital radio. There are some good presenters out there. Online radio is good too. Some excellent little shows. I have no problem going to an online station. But it's fair to say that having FM experience on your CV still counts. Yeah, you're quite right there. Quite right there. I did Liberty Radio in London, didn't I? That's a long time ago. It was 17 years ago I did that. 17 years. And it was 2 till 6:30 in the morning. I'll never forget one day. I nearly fell asleep. I mean, I got the job because someone kept falling asleep. That's true. And I was sitting there one day and all of a sudden, it was like someone suddenly turned all the power down. It kind of went dim and my hearing level dropped by 50%. I thought, my God, what's happening here? And I'd got exhausted. Anyway, I carried on and I managed to get home and we just slept for ages after that. I do swear on the tennis court. Oh, is that how comes you're so thin? Is that what we all got to do? Go and play tennis? I mean, this shirt is so tight today. I thought I'd get away with it. Can you see the button straining? Look. I can't wear this at work tonight. My God, this is tight this morning. I do swear on the tennis court, usually under my breath, as I lump a ball long, wide, into the net. That's another story. Take care and see you at the quiz next month, unless I pop into Central Station before then. Ray is trying to get you along on a Monday. You should come to Central Station. You'd like it there. Come and have a little bit of a sing-song there. All right? Call in if you want to. 0208 144 3477 is the phone number, right? 0208 144 3477. Good morning to Warren this morning. Warren says, I'm bored. I'll think I'll turn on James O'Brien. Well, good luck, mate. Oh, God. He's had second thoughts. I would say so. Did you listen to... I turned it on yesterday and there were two... I heard two words and that was enough for me. I turned it off straight away. Mr. Left Wing himself, James O'Brien. Why don't he just... Perhaps he'd like to lead the Labour Party. Eh? I think... James O'Brien might like to lead the Labour Party. Good luck. He's very, very intelligent. I could never have a conversation with him. My God, I'd fall asleep. He is so boring, so boring. Thank you, Warren. Adam says, with the clock, move the cross above your star award and then put the clock in the press. Move the cross above your star award. Do you think that would go there? Yeah, actually, it might do that. No, but then we've got two clocks next to each other. I think maybe the clock up there, actually. Let's have a look. Where is it now? Because this is a very special thing. This is from lots of very special people. Oh, you see my stomach there. I don't know. No, I think there, actually. I think it might go there. But you can't see all of it, can you? Can you? Well, maybe you can. I don't know. We'll find somewhere to put that. My Norfolk Island clock. Very nice indeed. Good. Ah, oh, Mary doesn't like James O'Brien either, does she? No, Mary, we don't like James O'Brien. Katie Hopkins. Yes, Katie Hopkins. I'm sorry to tell you. I do like Katie Hopkins. I do. I really do like Katie Hopkins. Some of your messages from yesterday's show, boys and girls. Joanna writes, on the subject of Skims diet. Skims. It's a bit like Weight Watchers. Apparently Skims diet. I've not heard of that one. And she says, congratulations to Adam for losing half a stone in 2 weeks. Well done, Adam. Well done, Adam. Joanna also says, it's not only portion control, but also the amount of carbohydrates, fats and sugars that you consume. Actually, I haven't weighed myself today. I should weigh myself before I come up. We're going to weigh ourselves. That's it. Every Friday now. Let me make a note of this on my calendar, which is filling up rapidly, I'm pleased to say. My calendar is filling up. Now, where is it? Tuesday, Friday. Friday the 3rd. That's 2 days before my birthday next week. where is it? Weigh myself. There we are. And I'll do it Monday as well. I'll do it Monday as well. So we'll do it Monday as well next week so that we can compare if there's any weight loss going on. Wait, there we go. Remind me to do that Monday if I do the show and I haven't told you what the weight is. Maybe I can do it with your help. If I start, if I share with you my weight, perhaps I can embarrass myself into actually losing a bit of weight. I've always had this thing about my weight. Terrible, terrible. Good morning to Simon Keane, who says, on the subject... Oh, I'm going to sneeze, am I? No, don't sneeze, Chris. On the subject of the comedy store, he reckons I should do stand-up comedy. I completely disagree with that. I really do, Simon. I could not... None of this is written down. This is just flowing, and there's a few bits in front. I've got loads of news stories. We haven't done any of these news stories this morning, have we? And we're nearly coming up to an hour. It's nearly time to go, gang. Nearly time to go. And he thinks I should do Comedy Store. I just totally disagree with that. I could not do it. Stand up. What if you freeze? You know, there's not much... what would you call it? There's not like a script to this show. Just a few bits written down here. That's all. There's not much written down there at all. That's all that's written down today. Look. But in front of me, I have bits of paper, news stories and all sorts of things like that. And I never seem to get to them. Simon says, ref the comedy club. They will laugh because the comedy store and those sort of clubs don't have idiots in. Just genuine, nice people. Trust me, there is not a person who would not like you. Oh, come on. No, Simon. No. I think you're talking... You don't... I mean, I don't understand it. I don't quite understand it either. I think you're completely wrong there. If they do not laugh, it's not good. But what you do is keep something you know is funny. And when you get that, they do laugh. You can unleash one that they... What? And if they do not laugh, yes, it's not good. But what you do is keep something you know is funny. And when you get that, they do not laugh. When you get that they do not laugh, you can unleash one and then they laugh. Well, what could I unleash so that they'll laugh? How about this? Would that make them laugh? Would that make them laugh, do you think? Donald Trump makes me laugh. Some of the stuff he comes out with. There was something else again this morning on the news. I can't remember what it was now. He asked me in stitches. It's like a reality show, isn't it? Watching what's going on over there. And Mother Teresa's there this morning. Mother Teresa's going to have a little chat with him today. Simon goes on to say, I know you have this thing with self-doubt and stuff. I have sometimes. But you have the love of all the regulars that come to karaoke nights. They keep coming because that's very nice of you, darling. So I'm not going to read that out. But thank you for the comments there. Simon also says, when you do the comedy store, comedy that leads to TV work as well. Well, I'm on the TV now, dear. What do you mean leads to TV? This is a worldwide international television. This is not a local, as I said to Ross earlier, who rang up. He said, is it BBC Radio Berkshire? No, it's not. This is an international television programme. Global, dear, global. Local, how dare you call me local? So that's it. I think that's all the comments on the show that that people left on the show yesterday. We're due today's birthdays. Let's bring up today's birthdays for your boys and girls. Let's see, where's our little birthdays? 1 minute. Oh, what have I got up there? Oh, no, that's the messages again. Ah, Chris, with all these news stories, you'll have to do the news at one. What, another show at 1 o'clock? I've got doctor today. Yes, I'm once again, I'm in bed and I feel like I'm laying on something on my side. This has been going on for a year and a half, or a year and a quarter, something like that. So that's that. Now, oh, I know what I've got to tell you. So I've also got an appointment at the hospital to look at my stomach because it blows up a lot. I don't think the stomach are the same as the intestines. Is that two different things? So I've got a feeling they're not going to find anything. I think this is just a consultation. Anyway, so I got the appointment through, right? And it's in about a month's time on a Monday at 9:50 in the morning. And it's in London. Royal Free in London, actually. 9:50 on a Monday morning. Now, for me to get that is difficult. For me to get there on a Monday morning, that is very difficult. So I rung up the appointment line. And, you know, press one, press two, eventually get through to someone. Well, I'm sorry, so unhelpful. So unhelpful. And it sounded like she had one of those voices. Or like, actually, it reminded me of a guy on LBC called Nick Majerison. Did you ever hear him? Oh, he was such a boring voice. How boring can you sound? No enthusiasm whatsoever. I can't bear people like, and there's a load of them around. Isn't there? Anyway. So I'm talking to this woman and she was so unhelpful. Oh, well, I can't see alternative appointment for you. If you want to cancel that, you would go back on the waiting list. Oh, right. So there's nothing there at all then? No, there's nothing there at all. If you want to cancel it, just tell me and I can put you back on the waiting list. And the way she was talking, it was like, take it or leave it. That's how she was talking. I said, would you suggest I take that? I'm sorry, sir. We can't advise you on whether you should take an appointment. She was so unhelpful. So in the end, I said, well, you better leave it like that and I'll do my best to get there. Yeah, well, I will get there. I will get there on time. It'll be a damn effort. I think I might actually take a train in on that day. But I hope they're not going to want to do anything. I've got this terrible fear that they're going to want to put a camera down. You got swallow this camera down. And please do not text in and tell me if you've had that done. Okay, because I don't want to know. Don't tell me what they're going to do. When I go for these things, if I have to have something that was the same with the old camera up the other way. I did not read what they were going to do. I'm not interested. Even when I went in to see the consultant, this was back in last March or May, somewhere around there. The consultant took me in the room and said, right, if I explain what's going to happen, I said, I'll just move. Before you start, I'd rather not. Let's just go in the room and you do what you have to do and I'll worry about it for that short period that I'm in there, not the time while I'm getting changed and all that. And that'll be right. He said, OK, yeah, no problem at all. Do I take it you don't want to know about the risks as well? No, don't tell me the risks. Let's just go in and get it done. An elderly lady, and I've told this story a few times, who was way in her late 80s. She had cataracts done on her eyes. And I said, what was it? She said, Chris, to be honest, it was no problem at all. The worst thing I did was read about what they were going to do to me, and that frightened the life out of me. She said, I wish I'd never read it, and I've never read about what they're about to do to you in a hospital or anything like that. You know, I don't know how they do root canals, anything like that. I'm not interested. You just go in, and for that period that you're in there, that's the only time you worry about it. Not the hours, or indeed the days and weeks leading up to something awful like that. So there we are. Ross says, don't go yet. I have messaged Tony Blackburn to see if he will call you. He is online at the moment and has just seen my request. Tony Blackburn is not going to call me. Are you mad? Are you mad? Why would Tony Blackburn call me? He is an international, globally renowned DJ. My hero DJ. He is not to be rung such minuscule people as myself, Ross. I do wonder what planet you're on sometimes, dear. God's sake, man. Good morning to Sarita, who's with us this morning. She says, I hope you're okay. All well, Sarita. Thank you. All well. And that's good as well. 020-8144-3477 is my number. 020-8144-3477 is my phone number. We're still getting these Facebook friend requests from scantily clad women. Are you getting that? There are loads of it. And as I've been talking about, people have started messaging me and said, I've started getting that as well. I'm getting about 10 a day now. This morning one isn't too explicit. It simply says, now, what's her name? Margaret Sage Curry is this woman's name. And she's, as I say, scantily clad. You know, she's got pouting lips like that again. And her message is, I want someone that loves to travel. Not looking for a hookup, but great ex is important too. Delete. Bye-bye, darling. Wrong sex. Oh, already removed. So that's good as well. Excellent. Now, are we done there? I think we might be done there. Yeah, we're done. We're done this evening, boys and girls. Or done this morning, boys and girls. Thank you very much. I'll do today's birthdays and then we'll disappear. Okay, so this morning, I think we've only got about four birthdays today. Let's have a look. Happy birthday to Norman Scott, internationally acclaimed DJ. He was a massive DJ, Norman Scott. He's 76 years old. He has met everyone. Everyone. He has met. He's got photographs of him, of all these stars and people like that. And he's a very, very, I've only met him once. He's a very, very good friend of my very good friend, Ray Reynolds. 76 today. Happy birthday, Norman. All right. Top of the morning to you, sir. Happy morning. Happy birthday. Happy birthday to fellow DJ Miles Pearsall, who's 36 today. Oh, you've still got one of those bodies. I used to have one of those bodies, Miles. He comes over in a little vest and everything like that. Happy birthday today to Bob Dale. And happy birthday to Mykal Forley. Happy birthday to you all. Here comes the song.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Norman, Miles, Bob and Mykal. Happy birthday to you.
All right, gang, have a lovely birthday today. Tonight, I'll be hosting karaoke. It's Friday night, so do come and join us at karaoke. Starts at 8:30 at Central Station Bar in Wharfdale Road, King's Cross. Completely free. It gets very, very busy there now on a Friday, so come along early. All right, once again, starting at 8:30 and finishing at midnight, it's Friday karaoke tonight at Central Station Bar in Wharfdale Road, King's Cross. Apart from that, have a lovely Friday. Thanks for watching and listening, and I'll see you again very soon. Bye-bye now.